Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. Today is the second video covering the pile caps, and in today's video I'm going to show you the rebar drawing, but also remind you why it is so critical to have all information all the time with you while you're doing the pile caps. And at the end of the video, having a look at the piling layout and piling schedule, we're gonna double check if our calculation for the pile caps are right. So yeah guys, let's go. So guys, before I'm gonna go to rebar, I just wanna show you all the information I gathered from all these drawings you could see on the last video. And I wanna tell you why it is so important to keep all them together. And it is so critical to know what's below you, what's at the level that we are working, and what's above us. As you can find different information there and very useful information. And actually this drawing showing even better to the last one what I mean actually. So you can see here the level we're working at, that's the working level, I called it this way. So this is our pile caps here, our drainage, which we have to do as we go in with the pile caps, and the rebar drawing, which I'm going to show you actually later as well. But what I mean to know what happened before, it's the piling layout. There's piles already there and we're going to be looking for them. We're going to be cropping the piles and prepare them for the pile caps. And actually this one we can use as well to compare our calculations for the cutoff level, as on the piling schedule there will be a cutoff level for the piles. This is actually only for us to double check this, as we're going to be doing the pile caps. This is already done, so we're going to be cropping the piles to make sure our pile cap is going to be done as per the detailed drawing and as per a GA drawing. But this is another double check for us, and it's worth to check it actually. That's why I put it here as a level below and working level. As I said, we got all this drainage or rebar, all this stuff, and level above, you can see the level above, it's a basement slab, and this is the place where we actually got the information about the columns and about the column setting out. And that's why we need to look into the future really, so we're going to know what's happening. And only then we are 100% sure we got all the information and we are good to go, and we're never going to make any mistake. So guys, I got the RC detail for the pile caps here, and I'm going to have a quick look. And as I said on the last video, I'm going to let you download all these things so you can have a look yourself as well. And if you got any questions, just you're going to come back to me. But I'm going to have a look at this two pilers here, PC2 2.7 by 9, 1400 deep. So this is actually okay. So it's very simple here. You can see it's going to be 32 mil U-bars. What we got a 16 mil U-bar on the sides. So this is very easy, and that will be much better if you're gonna download this and you're gonna have a look yourself. So that's another pile cap here. But what I want to show you here, that's the most important information and the most important thing why we're gonna be doing the pile caps, is the column starters. As especially when why we're gonna be ordering the steel and we're gonna be doing the columns, we need to make sure the steel for this is gonna come with the starter bars and with drainage. So I just found it here, you can have a look. This is the information here for column starter details, refer basement to first floor. So that's again what I said. We working at this level here, we're doing the pile cap, but then look into the future guys, look into the basement slab, as there will be information which we actually need now at this moment, as later there is no chance we're gonna install any starter bars. And believe me guys, mistakes like this happen, as you need to remember that RC frames, this is a very busy environment and it's not that easy to be well organized, and that's why you need all this information like I'm showing here, just to avoid any mistakes really. We got the pile caps drawing here, as I said they're really simple, but we're gonna be now looking for the columns. And I got these drawings here. I'm going to show you, this is actually the basement to first floor column. So that's what I'm saying, basement. No one says about the pile caps here, but you need to have these starters while we're going to be doing the pile caps. So this is a sheet one. The reason I'm going to show in this sheet one is because there is a layout for the columns here, and that's actually the area I was looking for, is these four pile caps here. And as you can see, we got column 77 and column 75 here. And we're going to have a closer look at these columns. These are not marked, as you can see here. This is block A and A5. So these two probably you're going to find in other drawing covering the block A1 and A2. So guys, I'm looking for the column starters for C75 and C77. And then we're going to have a quick look at the basement drawing and just do the last double check if there is no discrepancy between the drawings and if there is no mistake done by the designer. So I'm going to go now looking for column 77. And 75. So these are these two columns here. And we guys at this level, we are only interested in this bit here, because we're going from the pile cap, we need the starter bar. So as you can see here, we're gonna have eight 20 mil bars here, L bars. We're gonna also need four links number one and four links number to as well, to install them in the pile cap. Installing links in the pile cap, that's another thing, guys. I'm going to tell a little bit more about this when I'm going to be doing the structure series, as these are not always needed, to be honest. But as I said, I'm going to try to cover it in the future. But we definitely need them 20 mil bars. And column 77, it's the same story. We need just this bit to make sure we're going to have a starter bars at the same time we're going to bring the steel for the pile caps. So I'm just going to take this bit here with us for that drawing. Just copy this and I'm going to put it here. So that will be this column. And well, we can have a look again. We just compare this with the basement slab and we want to make sure if the information is correct. So I actually took this from the basement slab drawing here. Column A and column B, there is two types here. I'll just show you in a minute as well, but it's 400 by 1 meter column, and this is correct here on the steel drawing. And this 400 by 400 column is here, C77, which is right as well. So I'll just quickly go here and show you the basement slab drawing here, confirming that this is A and B. So you can see here, this is column A and column B, so that's right. The dimensions are okay, and actually the rebar drawing is okay. But what else we need for the rebar drawing, as you remember probably, we're gonna need the rebar schedule as well. And I got the schedules here, and obviously we're gonna need first for the pile caps, once we're gonna be ordering the pile caps. And as you remember, we're doing here, I'm showing you the PC2, and the other one I'm showing you the PC2A. So that's gonna be all this. This is PC2A again. So we're gonna need this steel for these pile caps. And as I said, when you download these things, you can go yourself through all this information, and if you got any questions, just come back to me and I'm going to explain you more, as I don't want to take too much time now covering all this information about the rebar. So I'm going to come back here, guys. We got all information about the pile caps, we got top of the concrete, we got the drainage, we got the reinforcement, we know what's going to happen on the basement slab, and we know as well what was happening before. And the last exercise maybe for this video, we're going to double check if this cutoff level is actually okay. So just to quickly show you, you see them, this is the same bit of the drawing. So pile 37 and 38 going to be for the PC2, and 39, 40, 41 going to be for PC3, but we're going to go only for PC2 here, which is the 1400 deep, and we got top here for the pile cap. So that's going to be, guys, our 42715 minus 1400, which is the depth of the pile cap, and plus 75 mil projections for the pile, and that should equal 41390. So let's have a look quickly, guys. 42715, as I said, minus 1400, which is the depth of the pile cap, and then plus 75 mil, and that's exactly what we got, 41390. So that's accurate now, 41390. We checked it. So the piling schedule is okay, actually, and maybe I should say our calculations are all right as well. And this is our double check for the cutoff level. And we are sure now at this time we're going to crop these piles to 41390, whatever happens. And we're good to go. And that's actually all we can do when we're going to be doing the pile caps. As I said, we got all the information now, guys, and this is very important. I got the drawing here. I took information from all these drawings here. So guys, you need to remember, when we're going to be doing the pile caps, you need all the information. I'm going to repeat it again. We have a pile cap layout here, we got a drainage drawing as well, we got a basement slab, and then we got the rebar drawing. Well, we're going to see, actually, in this case, basement to first floor columns, and we're going to take the starters from these drawings. We found them columns here. Whatever columns we're going to be looking for, we have to look for them, obviously, through the drawings, covering all these buildings here, and there is many sheets for each building, so that's a lot of looking for as well. And then obviously we got the pile cap RC detail drawing as well, with the schedule, and that's going to be same for the columns. Maybe, guys, I'm just going to quickly come back to these columns. We had number 75, and we're going to be looking for this here. So I'm just quickly go to the schedule and just to mark up for us what we are looking for. It was column 75, so that's the column here. But the most important thing, guys, we only need the starter bar, so that's going to be what we need. We need number 1, 2, 3 at this level. And All the rest is going to be ordered in the future when we're going to be doing the basement to the ground floor slab, and then another one from the ground floor slab to the first floor slab. So that's a little bit of playing here, and this is very easy to make a mistake. But once you're doing the basic engineering stuff in terms of setting out and maybe the quality checks, you don't need these things. And I'll obviously cover this. I'm gonna do separate video about the call-offs and what you have to look for while you're gonna be doing them. So guys, I think that will be all in today's video. And as I said before in the last video, I changed a little bit the way I'm showing this. And please leave me the comments. Let me know if you like the way. I think once I'm gonna let you download the thing so you can have a look yourself, I think the way I'm showing this now is much better as well. And just guys, as you can see on these drawings, I collected all information from plenty other drawings. And that's how you should be looking, and that's our engineering job, just to combine all the drawings, take all information we can get, maybe even like this, put them on the one drawing. And also we're gonna create like a working drawing, what I was showing during the capping beam. So that's how we're working. So yeah, thank you again for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and leave the comments, guys. If you want to know more, just ask me questions. I always reply to them as soon as possible. And also guys, let me know if you like the way I'm showing these drawings now, as I'm gonna probably keep it this way. So yeah guys, thank you again, and see you next time.